that tour was really interesting, don't you think?
Are you ready to try your luck?
Poison, I see, hath been his timeless end. Oh, churl, drunk all and left no friendly drop. Oh, happy dagger, this is thy sheath. There, rust, and let me die.
The door slammed shut. Please wait a minute. I'll find the spare key.
Hi, I'm Drya Crowley. What a wonderful performance. That was clearly not an act, but a veritable display of the feelings of two hearts in love. I'm holding a ball tonight. You must perform there. I promise you'll be incredibly famous. You do realize that you'll starve if you stay in this dump, don't you? Your talent shouldn't be wasted here in the middle of nowhere. I'll ask the owners of some major theaters to give you a role in their famous plays. All the guests are already waiting at my estate. If you agree, we need to go right now, or you may not have the time to prepare anything.
Mr. Crowley, thank you for your generous offer, but we must wait for Franz. He went to get pieces of scenery for the next show.
We can't waste another minute. Leave Franz a note telling him to meet us at the estate. I have a little gift for you. Take it. This will come in handy.
Dear Franz. I have wonderful news for you. Dryer Crowley invited us to perform at the ball at his estate. I have to go now, or we won't be able to prepare everything on time. We'll be waiting for you at the estate. Your Beatrice.
It's a pretty long drive to my estate. Would you mind passing the time by having a glass or two? Let's drink to your talent, young lady.
Mr. Crowley invited us to perform at the ball. What luck! I need to hurry to the estate. Beatrice's pendant? What happened here? She would never leave it. too noisy in the estate. Nobody will hear me.
Welcome. My name is Eve. I'm Mr. Crawley's butler. He said you were coming. Mr. Crawley is expecting... The ball will begin soon, so I have to go. You may go to the office for now.
Hello, my name is Margaret Boleyn, and I'm an owner of some of the major theatres in the city. I'm also a longtime friend of Mr. Crowley's family. Wait, I know you. I saw your performance at the local theatre. You must be looking for your fiancée. She's already with Mr. Crowley in his office. He put in a word for you, and I would be happy to give you a job at one of my theatres. I was just about to go upstairs when I suddenly twisted my leg. The heel broke, and now I can't go anywhere. And please, think of something to help me. In return, I'll take you to the second floor to see Mr. Crowley.
Ah, my leg!
Oh, thank you. These shoes fit perfectly. You're very lucky, young boy. Your fiancé is probably tired of waiting for you. Follow me. I'll take you to Crowley's office. And here, take it as a token of my gratitude.